How did you not do the guys? Welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa, Havoc. With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We got lit on an absolute goose chase. Like, I've not seen Optimus Prime yet, but we've got a picture of him, so I assume he does exist. But it just seems like we've been running up and down the stairs all the time, and in the middle of, obviously, Fumi's been murdered, so we need to investigate what's going on and actually catch it. Because I think there's more going on than... there's more going on behind the scenes than... is like just being shown on the screen, if you know what I'm saying. It just feels like there's something bigger going on behind everything, like, because we're running up and down, like, none of us have seen Optimus Prime yet, so or whatever the robot's name is. So as far as I can tell, there's nobody here, but still I feel some kind of presence. Yeah, sure can feel someone's presence. This presence, is it coming from over there in the back in here? Let us go check it out. I leapt through the doorway. When I did, I found another nightmare. The second nightmare of the day was waiting there to greet me. Wait, what? Someone else? Oh, Super Saiyan Shimaru. There, in a pool of his own blood, was Taka. Dead. Holy shit, so two people have died. Oh dear. It's not against rules either. It says the killer can kill a maximum of two people. So I guess the killer has murdered two people in this instance. So someone must have known what was going on. So that's the only thing I can think of. Like, you've got no other real excuse to kill two people. Fumi's body discovered in the nurse's office. Taka's body discovered in the equipment room. I was witness to two nightmares, one right after another. No, they weren't nightmares. This is harsh reality. Jesus, now I've got to investigate this. And I assume that I'm going to be one that's straight on investigating because everyone else is a bit useless. The true nightmare is this reality. Reality I have to face. Is that Kirigiri? Kirigiri's okay. Maybe Celeste. Tagami can go rot in hell. Why is this happening? I'm interested at the moment, actually. Because there's... Let me just check something. I want to go check the rules or something. That's the report card. I'm going to check the regulations. Because Monokuma is an absolute stickler for these things. Yeah, night time is from 10 AM. See if anyone in the dormitory will be seen. Cost of money. We need to explore HP Academy at our discretion. It's against Headmaster, blah blah. Let's see how this goes. Some meditates, place control. Also, my students. So, the other one I didn't know my students. Yeah, there you go. May only kill a maximum of two people during any single killing game. Okay, so this is the maximum number of people that's going to be killed, so. School regulations, maybe. Okay, I'll see. Right. Okay, so let's speak to Tagami, because he normally knows. He probably already knows what's happened. Oh, okay. Oh, shit. I assume she saw blood and fainted. Toko? Don't tell me. Toko too. Relax. She just passed out when she saw the blood. The blood? Oh, that's right. When Toko is, Toko, she has a fear of blood, huh? We've tried everything to get her to wake up, but no luck. Just leave her be for now. It's like you said. Just leave her alone for now. She'll come back as, genocide joint. This thing. Jesus Christ, that's my sort of hammer. Gimli would be proud, even though he has axes more than hammers. Another hammer. No, it's just this hammer 4, and it's even bigger than before. Is that suspicious individual responsible for killing Taka too?
But why is it Justice Hammer 4?
Huh? What do you mean?
Celeste was attacked with Justice Hammer 1. Then Ifumi was hit with Justice Hammer 2. But this time it was Justice Hammer 4. What happened to number 3?
Ah, oh, these guys don't know, do they? What's the matter? Well, when you mentioned Justice Hammer 3, you just reminded me.
Out of it, do you know something?
Actually, Taka's not the only one that's been killed. Ifumi's dead too.
What?
Hey. Ifumi's been killed.
Yeah.
I see.
Which is why you came to get us. We're ready to go check it out.
Of course, come on.
We can't leave this body. So Sakura, Byakuya, and I rushed out of the physics lab. You've just left Toko in there with a body, but as soon as we were out of the physics lab...
Oh!
Celeste, I'm supposed to be waiting in the nurse's office.
Something has come up.
Yes, I heard. Ifumi's dead, right?
Indeed.
Well, that is not all. It is gone.
Huh? What's gone?
It has disappeared.
Disappeared?
Ifumi's body has disappeared.
What?
What did you say?
What are you talking about? It's disappeared? Don't be ridiculous. Again with wild goose chase. Like, what is going on? Can't we all just, like, rope together and stay in one place?
Come on.
Are you serious?
What the heck is happening here? Everyone, back to the nurse's office.
I'm probably leapt down the stairs and losing my balance. You should nurse's office completely out of breath. And where's Kirigiri in all this, man? Couldn't believe my eyes. Oh dear. Fumi's body was there just a few minutes earlier. It just disappeared?
Me and Sliss went to the bathroom. We were only gone for like a minute. And then when we got back...
Indeed.
This must be the work of a culprit. They must have come and carried the body away. They must really be enjoying this. Giant sight for standing around, frightened and confused. We're all going to die here. We're going to die, just like those guys died.
What did you say?
I don't believe this. Don't believe a body would just disappear. Why? First there are two murders, and now one of the bodies has been taken. This is... unnatural.
Huh? Well, hold on, what do you mean two murders?
Tark has been killed. We found him in the equipment room.
No way!
It can't be. Takatu! It can't be. It can't be.
Calm down.
We're not gonna die. All of us are gonna kill all of us.
Then who might the next target be, Toko?
What? I completely forgot. She's still unconscious in the equipment room.
The left her at the scene of a crime.
We didn't have a choice. She passed out and she refused to wake up.
So she's still unconscious.
Wait, so you knew she was still up there and said nothing? Why?
That's not only the set that clings to me wherever I go. We'd be better off without her. She can't... We've got two dead bodies, so more can't appear.
You bastard.
Calm down. You forgot about her, didn't you? You have no right to blame me. Everyone stop fighting. Right now we need to hurry back.
I can't save this anymore. I don't want anyone to die.
Yuck. If something's happened to Toko, I'll never forgive you.
She can't... There's already been two corpses. If there's more murders, then Monokuma's gonna lose his shit. We shot off the nurse and bottle up the stairs, heading back to the third floor. Ran back to the equipment room at full speed, and when we got there... Of bloody course. Toko. Thank God you're okay. Right away I noticed. There's something very different here.
I wonder what it is.
It's gone. Taka's body, which should have been right here, had disappeared.
This
can't be happening.
Are we hallucinating all this or something?
No, it's not a hallucination. I know I saw it before. What I'm seeing now isn't what I saw before.
Huh? What? I've seen Taka disappear too.
Stop saying disappeared. It didn't just vanish into thin air. Obviously whoever did this has hidden the body. But why would they do that? I couldn't possibly begin to imagine.
Anyway, our costume suspect is clearly continuing his crime spree. We gotta hurry up and catch him before he kills all of us.
Not possible.
Oh, I don't think you have to worry about that.
Huh?
Think about it. Who could possibly be responsible for killing and hiding these dead bodies? When Ifumi's death went up, everyone here was together on the third floor.
It is so.
After that, we split up into two groups.
And now this time, you all came here as a group from the nurse's office. In other words, the only ones who could have done this are Hiro and Kyoko, who are still missing. Hold on a second. Kyoko has an alibi for when Celeste and Ifumi were attacked. I'm having a thought here, okay? What if one of the bodies wasn't actually a body? Because out of everyone, Kyoko's been the only one but shown any sort of, like, non-give a shit about touching a body to check if he's to actually verify if the person's actually dead. No one else will have done that. So perhaps one of the other bodies wasn't actually a body. Was it the actual killer pretend? So it could have been Taka or Ifumi as well. So I'm not going to rule them out. I'm going to rule those out for now because I know the way this game works from the past cases. It could be anything. Think outside the box. Okay. There's no question that she was in the dining hall with us. Seemed very adamant about defending her. Perhaps you are enough.
You're goddamn right I am. She's awesome.
That's not it at all.
Yes, it is.
Well, anyway, yes, I do accept Kyoko's alibi.
She means the special energy you're looking for can be none other than Hiro.
Which further means there'll be no more murders. The regulations are very clear about that. Oh, that's right. There's a rule that says you can only kill a maximum of two that's people. Right. As long as that rule is in place, there will not be a third murder. If they were to break that rule...
Mincia! Mincia, without a second thought! Mincia, grant you turn you to paste! By the way, do you know that fish paste can also refer to shellfish? Like shrimp or crabs?
Indeed.
<Let's see.
laughs> Bye, Manikuma!
So since two people have been killed, there is no possibility of any more.
Perhaps.
You knew that from the beginning, didn't you, Byakuya? Which means you knew Toko was never in danger.
I still meant when I said we'd better off without her, though.
In other words...
Anyway, with that in mind, we can now relax and search over two missing bodies. Two missing bodies. Two people have been killed, and their bodies have been hidden. The one without an alibi, the only one who could have done it, is Hiro. But is he really the killer? Not too sure Hiro has got it in him, but we'll see. Maybe he might be in debt or something. And what about Kyoko? She's not involved in the case, where did she go? Hey Makoto, what's the matter? Oh, no, it's nothing. Whatever, we need to find those bodies. Our little narrative here can't move forward.
So then...
Stop touching on the fourth wall, Tagami. See what you're doing there.
Very well, let us split up and begin searching.
But...
There's no need to be afraid. No more murders will take place during the case. I think I do, but...
If you're still nervous, I'll come with you.
Okay, thank you.
No need to thank me.
Then let's get moving. You'll out if you find anything. Bianchi left the equipment room followed by the others. After trying to find the two missing bodies. Okay, I want to go check. I want to recheck the crime scene first, though. Okay, because it was like the bloodstain was a bit interesting. It seemed to be a. Okay, so my PC just started a little mini freak out there, so I've opened up my task manager to keep an eye on everything. So just continue. I want to go check the crime scene first because I noticed the bloodstain seemed a bit off. So Toko's still there. She's gonna come back as Genocide Jill any minute now. I can tell you now. So just have a quick look at. Look, we see those tracks there. Toko's entire body's just been leaving nothing but a bloodstain. Yeah, can we not investigate that further? No wonder his hammer is made of wood. It's even bigger than the others. Just his hammer 4. Is this the work of all of a suspicious individual? It's gotta be, right? Okay, fine, let's go look for the bodies. Okay, so I found Sakura and Hina, so let's just speak to these guys first.
We need to search for the bodies that have disappeared. What happens after that?
We need to investigate, because we're now against Monokuma's Clock of Boredom.
Where could two bodies have disappeared to?
Now look in here. Right or wrong? Huh? The door must be locked. Why would it be locked, bro? We need to get in there. Okay. So we need to... Sakura, can you kick that down while we're gone? Thank you. Okay, there's nothing in here but the hammer. So let's have a quick look at the hammer. Celeste. Should we really attack with this Justice Hammer 1? What the heck is with this thing?
Makoto.
Come on.
Why are you just standing there? We need to get to the repository. Eh? You mean...
Indeed.
I found them. Fumi and Taka's bodies have both been hidden in the repository.
Goodbye.
I've already told Hina and Sakura. We'll go on ahead. The bodies are in the repository. Okay, let's go over there then.
Pretty sure we'll just try getting in there though.
Are the bodies here somewhere?
Tagami, tell me.
I have to wonder where they could have been hidden. In here, were they not? Overhead is the repository of the doorknob turned. Who unlocked it? I guess it's not. They have no choice but to go inside. Celeste found them. Did she have a key? That doesn't make sense. So open the door. When I entered, I saw... the giant mound that is Hifumi. The two bodies that had disappeared were right there. The smell of blood made me gag. What I saw before my eyes was unquestionable, unavoidable, unwavering reality. And then, I heard the announcement for a second time. That's it! That is it! So... One of these bodies was not dead before, because otherwise the announcement would have rang out.
After a
certain amount of time, which you may use however you like.
One of these guys wasn't dead before when we checked them out. Otherwise, Monokuma would have put this. Cause each instance was definitely three people that found the body.
Hmm. So here we are.
It's the Monokuma file.
Without further ado, let me give you over the next Monokuma file. I was going to hand them out when you found the bodies the first time, but I thought something might happen. Well, I had to resist, but turns out I was right.
Just hand it over already.
Punishment is waiting for
now,
you.
Make sure to investigate with all your mental might and prepare for the class trial.
See ya later.
Well, at least I think there was three people there when I went into like the nurse's office and saw Hifumi. There was me, Hina, and who was the other person? I can't remember. I think it was definitely three of us. I don't know. I'm trying to remember. My memory's not that great anyway, but I think that's going to play into it at some point. One of the bodies definitely wasn't dead, I don't think. Well then, now we found the bodies, all that's left is to uncover the culprit.
Oh, hold on. How can it be so calm?
We have to be, Hina. Come on.
I mean, they're dead, you know.
That's terrible.
They're gone forever. They're never coming back.
And we'll all be dead too if we don't find out who did it.
Awful. This is all just too awful.
Hina suddenly burst into tears. She crushed Ifumi's lifeless body.
Who would do this? Why? Why?
Jesus Christ, man. It's been one wild goose chase, hasn't it? And like, two people have died because of it. Large wet tears fell from her eyes. Large wet tears. Is that how you're really going to describe them, Makoto? Wet tears. Water is wet. The tears landed on Ifumi's cheeks. If this were some world of make-believe, that might have been when Hifumi opened his eyes. But this wasn't a movie. It's a video game! Oh, there she goes with the wet tears. Oh, shit! Wait, what? This wasn't...
He's alive again? Where am I?
But the body announcement's gone off. So he should be dead. Should have punches him in the face. Die, die.
Cold. So cold.
Don't. No.
Winter coming.
Just Ned Stark comes up. Winter is coming.
Ifumi, wake up! Huh? That's right.
Give us a clue. Tell us who bashed your head in.
Now. Hope's peak. Come on, you gotta wake up!
Oh man.
I remember everything before I met you all. I met you all.
What? His memories are all blending together. He has nothing useless to offer us.
The light. It's reaching out to me.
Go draw your fanfiction in heaven.
Like the tail of a comet.
Hey, Ifumi! Who was it? Who attacked you? Who tried to kill you?
Who killed me? That's right.
Oh.
I remember.
Say it.
Their name. Yasu.
Yasu.
Hero.
Hero. What? What? His eyes closed, may never open again. Death for the second time. Absolute undeniable death. Oh Jesus. No matter how many more of Hina's tears splashed his face, it was no second miracle. Reality set in again. This isn't some stereotypical fantasy world. Tears can't restore a person's vitality.
Honestly.
You have no tears, do you? No blood in your veins, no calcium in your bones. At least you have your meat.
You're just angry. Going out of his way to return, just to leave us with those unnecessary dying words. Now this game has become exceedingly boring.
You said Yasuhiro, right?
Then perhaps...
Yasuhiro Hagakure. He's the only person you could have been referring to.
So in other words...
And with that, the case is off. No. Let's not jump to conclusions. We've investigated... assaulting people and even killing Taka Nifumi. Even so far as to hide their bodies. Coming over hides his face behind a mask and uses a bunch of giant wooden hammers. Is that what a hero is?
What is this?
If it's true, I can't forgive him. No way can I ever forgive him. To kill two of our friends.
That's fine.
Anyway, it's about time we track down the culprit in our little life or death game here. Although, this time it's not all that life or death. The trial concludes without much trouble.
Indeed.
Yes, it does look that way.
It's going to begin again. I have to go through this one more time. I have to accept it. I have no choice but to go through with this to make sure everyone survives. Just have to do it.
I like to do it, do it.
Boom!
First, I'd better check the Monokuma file. The victims were Hifumi Yamada and Kiyotaka Ishimaru. The cause of death for each was a blow to the head. It is thought they were both killed with similar weapons, so both hammers then. That's
very
it.
Strange.
Yeah, it's pretty strange. We got way less information this time than before.
That is no problem. After all, the events of this case unfolded before our very eyes. We should know more about what happened than the Monokuma file cut anyway.
Maybe.
Well, there's something else that's bothering me. Someone else has been missing for quite a while.
Talking about Kyoko.
Without a doubt, she has an alibi for when Celeste and Hifumi were attacked. What if the killer wasn't acting alone? What if I had an accomplice?
An accomplice?
An accomplice?
What are you
doing here? Dummy-roo! I'm here to answer your question!
What question?
Yep. You're talking about accomplices, right? Pretty sure I explained before, didn't I? During the first class trial.
Speaking of which, I'd like to ask the bear, if there is an accomplice, do they also become blackened?
So you ask, and so I shall answer.
No, only one that did the killing gets away with it.
To have an accomplice, but only the one who does the killing will get to graduate.
So there's no point, is there?
So in other words, two people can work together, but one of them has no chance of profiting from it.
Then there's no way anyone would work together, right?
Unless someone's obsessed with someone.
In other words,
you can't even use blackmail because you're going to get killed anyway, so...
So basically, you can be an accomplice if you want, but there's no gratification in it.
So are you saying nobody worked together this time either?
Sorry, can't answer that. I would obstruct a free exchange of information between you guys. Only make sure you don't forget, no matter how much you might assist in the murder, only one blackman can graduate. An accomplice gets nothing!
So in other words...
So we need to figure out who that one blackened is for the killing, right? Just like normal.
Well, okay, I'm gonna take some shit to clarify the whole shebang! In this class trial, what I need to do, miss...
Scream!
One true blackened who devised the murder plot and put it into action.
True blackened, so just one person.
Well, now.
That's enough for explainifying. Now it's down to the final battle to win off you, with a blackened. Total 12 contestants!
Contender! Ready! Blackened! Ready! Fight! Let them fight!
So it can only be one blackened and a accomplice benefit. Then I can't see any way Kyoko will be connected to this case after all. You may be right.
That's true then. Kyoko, where are you?
However...
As long as she's not connected to the case, doesn't matter. Let's get back to the investigation.
I have absolutely no doubt that Hiro is responsible. For the time being, I suppose they can't have to pursue further information. Don't you think we should consider certain someone as suspecting just in case? I'm talking about the murderous fiend, Genocide Jet.
What?
I'm offended.
Ooh.
Ah!
You, when did you...
I've been looking out loud for you, Master. When I woke up, you were nowhere to be found.
You S.O.B.
Anyway, you there, Milksack Swimmer Girl.
Huh?
Milksack?
You gotta be kidding.
Why do I gotta be a suspect?
What the heck?
Well, I mean, you are a serial killer. So what? I'm like special suspect every time. I have an alibi, you know.
She's right about that. When we heard Ifumi scream, she was with me. And then the bodies disappeared. She was still lying unconscious in the equipment room. Plus, Taka's body aside, I can't imagine any way she would have been able to move Ifumi's body.
Yep.
Besides, I calculate every move I make. I'm not gonna kill someone so everyone else knows what I look like. I don't come in from this thing for nothing.
What are you saying?
It's not the kind of thing you should be bragging about.
Let's see.
But another topic. Should we post a guard by the bodies like before? Can't have him disappearing again.
Hina and I can handle that. You don't mind, do you, Hina?
Sure, I was told there was some investigation anyway.
It's all clear now.
We must fight. Let's begin.
Yes! This whole thing is so strange.
One of us has an alibi, so figuring out who did it should be obvious, right? But... Maybe it's just me, but I don't think it's going to be so straightforward as it seems.
Because we're in a video game!
Okay, Monokuma Falvey is mad to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Okay, so we shall investigate this in the next episode because I'm out of time for this one. So, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.